Welcome students to class 4 maths lesson 4 subtraction session 3.2. Before we start the session, let us visit our kids corner. Here I would like to congratulate Rohan and Ashi for their performance in the previous video on Roman numerals. If you want your name to be featured in one of the kids corner, do like the video and leave a comment in the comment section telling me about your performance in today's worksheet. Subtraction with borrowing. First, let us recall decomposing or borrowing. 1 tens is equal to 10 ones. 100 is equal to 10 tens. 1,000 is equal to 10 hundreds. And 1 10,000 is equal to 10 thousands. Example, subtract 2,800 from 5,000. We cannot subtract directly because one of the numbers is in hundreds and one of the numbers is in thousands. So from 5,000 we have to subtract. So we will convert 5,000 to hundreds, which will become 50 hundreds, because 1,000 is equal to 10 hundreds and 2,800 will remain 2,800 only. Now we can subtract 50 minus 28 and then get the answer. So which gives us 2,200. That is our answer. Subtract 5, 6, 3, 4 from 8, 1, 2, 3. So we will write 8, 1, 2, 3 on top. Minus 5, 6, 3, 4. We will start from the rightmost column. That is the ones column, 3 minus 4. Now students, if you have 3 chocolates, can you give 4 chocolates to somebody? You cannot. So from 3 you cannot subtract 4. You will have to borrow from the neighbor. So the neighbor is 2 in the tens place. We'll cut 2 and write 1 on top. And here that 1 from tens column, when it comes to ones column, it becomes 10 ones. 10 ones plus 3 ones makes it 13 ones. So 3 we'll cut and write 13 on top. And 13 minus 4 we can do, that is going to be 9. Now let's come to the tens column. We have 1 minus 3. We can't do 1 minus 3. So again we go to the left side neighbor, which is 100s. We'll cut this 1, write 0 on top. Now when a 100 comes to the tens column, it becomes 10 tens. So 10 tens plus 1 ten will be make it. We'll cut 1 and write 11 tens. 11 minus 3, 8. Now the hundreds column, we have 0. From 0 you cannot give away 6. Again we go to the thousands column, which is the column on left. And take 1 out of there. Cut 8 and write 7 on top. 1000 from the thousands column, which comes to the hundreds column, becomes 10 hundreds. 10 hundreds plus 0 hundreds is 10 hundreds. So 0 cancels and becomes 10. 10 minus 6 will give us 4. Now last column we have, thousands column, 7 minus 5, which is 2. So this is how we get the answer as 2, 4, 8, 9. And when we write it in number sentence form, we write it as 8, 1, 2, 3 minus 5, 6, 3, 4 is equal to 2, 4, 8, 9. Another example, find the difference between 9, 5, 6, 3, 2 and 6, 3, 2, 5, 4. Now here, look at the question carefully. They have asked us to find the difference between two numbers. Here, they can write a bigger number in the first place and the smaller number in second place, or they could write the smaller number first and then the bigger number. We have to look at both the numbers, see which is bigger, and then write the bigger number first. So we have identified the bigger number is 95632. We will write it on top. Below it, we'll write 63254. Then subtract. You may pause the video, do the subtraction, and then I will show you the answer. Now students, I have written all the borrowing and then written the answer. So in case you have gone wrong somewhere, you can check yourself. Answer to this is 32378. Now let us do a worksheet to enhance our understanding further. And after the worksheet, I have shared the solutions. Solve the complete worksheet on your own and then go to the solutions to check your answers. Question 1. Subtract A part 37,000 from 51,000. So here it is a very easy question. Both the numbers are in thousands. You just have to subtract B part
5,500
from 46,000. Now you'll have to convert 46,000 to hundreds first and then you'll do the subtraction. C part 1,200 five tens from 7,000. Now you'll have to convert the 7,000 to hundreds and then to tens and 1,200 to tens. So now the 7,000 will be 70 hundreds and 70 hundreds will further have to go down to tens, that is 700 tens. But the first number 1,200, you'll have to convert it into tens. So that is going to be 120 tens. Plus 5 tens, so it will be 125 tens. And this 7,000 I'd already told will be 700 tens. Good enough clue for you? I'm sure you can do it now. Question 2, subtract 9443 minus 8752. Question 3, 63291 minus 48465. Write in columns and subtract 7562 minus 3629. Here, they have told us to write in columns and they have given the number sentence form. So, we know which number is coming first, which number is coming in the second line. You just have to write one below the other. Question 5. Write in columns and subtract 53625 minus 22598. This question is similar to the previous question. Then, sixth one. Find the difference between 9537 and 3591. Now they have asked us to find the difference between two numbers. So we will first see which is the bigger number. That is 9537 is bigger. So we will write this number first and then the next number below it and subtract. Question 7. Find the difference between 23156 and 65324. Now here again, you'll have to look at both the numbers, see which is bigger, and then write the bigger number on top. Question 8. Fill in the blanks. Question 9. Fill in the blanks. Now solutions to the worksheet 4.2. Now students, you can pause the video here. Go back. See the questions again. Please look at the solutions only after you have attempted all questions on your own. There is no problem if you do it wrong, but you should at least identify where you go wrong so that you can correct yourself. Now let us look at the solutions. Question 1, 37,000 from 51,000. So here we will not change anything because both are in thousands. We'll write 51,000 on top. Below that we'll write 37,000 and we will subtract. We get 14,000. That is our answer. B part we have 5,500 from 46,000. Now 46,000 we will convert it into hundreds. 1,000 is equal to 10 hundreds. So 46,000 is equal to 460 hundreds. We just have to add 10 and convert it to hundreds. Now 5,500 we will not convert it to anything. We'll just write it below this. 5,500 is equal to 5,500 and then we will subtract. We will get 405 hundreds. Now the C part. 1,200, 5 tens from 7,000. So we'll take the 7,000, convert it into tens. So from thousands to 100, you add 10. From 100 to tens, you have to add another 10. So total of 2 zeros have been added to 7 to make it into a tens. 1,200, 5 tens will become 125 tens. This I had explained while telling you the question. 1,200 will become 120 tens. 120 tens and 5 tens together will make 125 tens. So now we have to do 700 minus 125, which is 575. So the answer is 575 tens. Question 2, subtraction. The answer to this is 0691. I have also marked where I have borrowed so that it helps you in understanding. Question 3. The answer to this is 14826. Do check your borrowing also, students. I have written the borrowing on top. Question 4. Write in columns and subtract. So, here we had to write the numbers one below the other before subtracting. That was one more step added for us. When you write them one below the other and subtract, the answer that you'll get is 3933. Question 5. Write in columns and subtract. Here the answer is 31027. Question 6. Find the difference between 9537 and 3591. Since 9537 was bigger, we have written that number on top and then subtracted. That was a point to be noted. And then the answer to this question is 5946. Question 7. Find the difference between 23156 and 65324. Here the second number is bigger. So the second number will be on top. That is 65324 minus 23156. And when we subtract, we get the answer as 32168. Fill in the blanks. We'll start with the ones column. Here 1 is less than 2, so we will borrow from the neighbor, that is 9. We will cut 9 and write 8. When the 1 from tens column comes to the ones column, it becomes 10 ones. 10 ones plus 1 ones will give us 11 ones. 11 minus 2 will be 9. So in the first blank, we will have 9. Then this has become 8. 8 minus what will give us 2. Now for this, we'll have to subtract 2 from 8. 8 minus 2 is 6. So 6 will come in this blank. Now you can cross check also. 8 minus 6 is 2. Moving on, from 2 we cannot subtract 7. So we will borrow from the neighbor. 4 we'll cut 4 and write. We will cut 4 and write 3. And bring that 1000 in the hundreds column, making it 10 hundreds. 10 hundreds plus 2 will become 12. 12 minus 7 we can do. That will give us 5. And here we are left with 3. So 3 minus 3, 0. This is the answer to the fill in the blanks. Next question, fill in the blanks. Now here again, students, from 1 we can't subtract 3. So we borrow from the neighbor. We'll cut 4 and write 3 on top. And then bring that 1 from there in the ones column. So that will become 10. 10 plus 1 will become 11. 11 minus 3 is 8. Then 3 minus what will give us 1? So we'll subtract 1 from 3, which gives us 2. So 3 minus 2 will give us 1. So we'll write 2 here. Then 9 minus 5, that is 4. We'll write 4. 8 minus dash is equal to 3. So we'll now subtract 3 from 8 and we get 5. So we'll write 5 here. And we can cross check again. 8 minus 5 gives us 3. Moving on to the 10,000 column, 6 minus dash is equal to 1. 6 minus what will give us 1? For this, we will subtract 1 from 6. 6 minus 1 is 5. So we will write 5 here and we'll get 6 minus 5, which gives us 1. This completes our fill in the blanks. Stay tuned to the channel and don't forget to like the video. And leave a comment in the comment section about your performance in the worksheet. Until we meet again, stay happy and keep learning.